Hello, everybody. Welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather. And today is going to be a messy one. At least I think it is. I've got a canvas tote bag that I've done a little bit of prep work on, but I'm not going to show that to you just yet. I've got a little small jelly plate out and a few other supplies. We're going to do some different techniques on creating some art on our canvas tote bag. And why would I do the canvas tote bag? Because I'm traveling later this month. So if this is your first time here to Kraaft It Live, let me explain just a little bit. We do a 1 hour live crafting show just about every Tuesday. And this month we're gonna have a couple at the end that are actually not going to be live. They will be pre-recorded Kraaft It, not so live episodes, and that hopefully you'll join us live for the chat. I will be there live in the chat, and even though I'm not live on screen, but I'm live now, so to totally confuse you all, hello and welcome. I've got with me my fabulous friend Sylvia. She's here to say hello and welcome to everybody and to get my transition camera over to the other side, right?
Yes, we're gonna do that. Okay, I want to say hi to everybody's here. We got some new faces too. Michael's here and Sandra. Miss you, Sandra. You should be in here. And Maria, who we know as Rhea, Jazzy, BJ, Arthur, Carol, Kimmy, Mary, Linda Wessel, Barbara Clark, Linz is here. Yay! You and everybody has been asking where you are, and if you go back in the comments, you'll see that everybody is Lynn's gonna here today. Is Lynn's gonna be here today? We miss you, sweetie. So glad you're back. Kathy's here, Jules, JC, Donna, Trisha, Angela, and Lassie. Lassie is really Jet, and she's from Denmark, and she's joining us today. We're glad that you're here, Lassie. And I'm sure I'm not pronouncing that right, so maybe I'll just go with Jet.
So we'll just say Jet.
Yeah. And then I'm going to put today's message up.
Oh, Angela's here too, by the way. I know you probably said her name, but Angela, this is the first time Angela Heather has been here live. So that's kind of awesome. I know she's followed over from Instagram. So glad to see you.
Welcome, Angela Heather. I like your name.
You know what would be really cool is if everybody said where they're like where they came from, if they remember where they first heard about the Kraaft Shaak. That'd be really cool.
Yeah, I like that. Where are you watching from today, everybody? We know Jet is from Denmark.
And no, I didn't mean that. No, I meant where they came from, like Instagram or that's what I meant. Don't worry about it. Never mind.
And if you want to tell us where you're watching from, that's fine too, okay?
Oh, we're gonna have some fun today.
I'm gonna put today's message up.
Sure, whatever.
Okay, there it is. Okay. Today's message: the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. That Proverbs 9:10. I like that verse. That's a very, very good verse.
All right. Thank you very much, Sylvia. I appreciate you allowing me to move on.
And I want to put this one up too. This is from Jules. Okay. Just love this. It's just so sweet of you, Jewel. I love to watch your show, Heather. Such a friendly, encouraging group. And it is. We have a great time, and everybody's warm and friendly and receiving of each other. It's wonderful. Okay, I'm trying to get that off.
Yeah, you know what is really awesome about that statement is that it really doesn't have anything to do with me. I love that you guys love watching the show, but most importantly, that you really enjoy each other's company. And that's been by far the biggest blessing of this whole endeavor. So, all right, so let's go through all of the supplies that I've got here. I'm just gonna real quick share with you that I've got a bunch of So Soft fabric paints, but I'm also going to use some regular acrylic paints. These are some neon colors. I might play with those. I always pull them out. I don't always use them. And then I do have some DecoArt gesso, and I'll show you that in a minute. And I'm going to try the Shimmer Mister on the canvas with some water. I've got a spray bottle of water as well. So we're going to mess with some stuff and see what we get. Just try some different techniques and see what happens. I've got a stencil. This seems to be like the favorite stencil. I continually pull this one out. And I've also got, from Canvas Corp, I've got a bag I was trying to find the tag so I could tell you what size it was. Here it is. The tag is saying it's an 11 by 14 tote bag, and it's gusseted, so it's a good sized bag. And then I've got a canvas flower that we're going to mess with too. So let me just take that off the packaging here, because we're going to use this as a stamp. Right after I get the staple out of it. Two staples. Okay. First thing that I want to do with my canvas flower is it's kind of flat. It's basically, it's just the trimmings of when they make these bags, they take the trims and they turn them into these flowers. So it's really cool because it's like, it would be waste in, you know, other companies, I'm sure, but they turn it into another product. So that's pretty cool. And then I like taking the frayed edge and just kind of pulling on this and letting those frayed edges just come to life. And that helps with the fluffing of it too, because it's a little less stiff. And I like doing that. And then I have all these strings hanging off of it. And I don't try to trim those too much. I kind of leave those. That'll add to some of the texture on the jelly plate. So I also have my jelly plate, and I've got the 6-inch round we're going to use, because you don't need much space. It just needs to be a little bit bigger than the canvas flower. And then I have some masking tape so we can tape down the stencil, and some other odds and ends. So we'll go as we go. We'll go through that. So the first thing I did was took a mailing box thingy and put it inside the bag. I had to trim it down a little bit, but it was just a leftover remnant from the old store. Reuse those packagings. Don't throw them out. You can use them inside your canvas tote bag. So how's everybody doing out there? I hope that if you're watching us live, you are commenting here. If you're watching us live on YouTube, which is a new thing you can do now, you can watch us live on YouTube. You just can't comment over there. So if you're watching us live on YouTube and you want to also chime in with your chat with the rest of us, then you'll have to come on over to thecraftshack.com. The link is in the description of the video, so you can find the link to the live show there. One thing to keep in mind as well is every month at the end of this month, I will set up the episodes for next month. And when you sign in, if you click the check all button, it will register you for all that are available to register for at once. And then you'll get reminders of the upcoming episodes and letting you know that if there was a cancellation or if there was a surprise coming up or any of those kind of emails that I send out, then you would be on the list to receive those because you registered for the upcoming class or show. So you want to check that check all box on the website when you're there before you register. All right, so are you following so far? I'm just taping down my stencil, and now I'm getting out the gesso. I love this technique. I love using gesso on the canvas fabric. This canvas is natural canvas. It's untreated. It is just like any other material that you would use at your, at the material store. Fabric, that's the word. Fabric is the word I was looking for, just so you know. All right, so I've got a sponge dauber here, and I'm just adding some gesso to my sponge dauber, using the lid to sort of pounce it off. Waste not, want not, right?
Right.
And make sure we get enough on there. I don't want to see any of the blue pouncer. That's what I'm looking for. Very white, but not too much. We want it to be creamy, but not so much that it's going to bleed underneath. Okay, and then I'm going to pounce it in to the stencil. Now my hands are going to get a little messy, because it wouldn't be Kraaft It Live if we didn't. And I'm just going to hold down my stencil. Now, I chose this stencil because I love all these swirls, and I've chosen this stencil a lot lately, it seems like, but I do own other stencils, believe it or not. I just like all the swirls in this one. Now, this doesn't have to be perfect. I mean, you can take your time, really, and tape down all the little bits and parts and pieces and make it perfect, but again, this is Kraaft It Live. We don't do anything perfect here.
And I'm so glad we don't.
Well, perfect's overrated, I think. I prefer to make some mistakes. And I mean, I know that that's what you're doing when you're in your studio, you're making mistakes. So doesn't it make sense that the person on screen should also make some mistakes and be able to teach you how to maybe get out of it or what to do then?
How to recover from it.
Yeah. All right, so pouncing, a little bit of rubbing it in there. I'm not going for perfect coverage either. So some places will be hit with more or less. That'll just add to the texture of the bag.
Texture.
All right, so the idea is that you would keep doing this all the way and then take it off carefully. I think I'll finish this one, but we'll take it off carefully and then we will re-tape it on the bottom so that we get the full image or the full front of the bag covered with a swirly patterned image. That's the idea.
Cool.
So that's pretty good. So basically take the tape off and the stencil off. So just all one unit like this, and you can just retape it down at the bottom.
Oh, cool.
Pretty neat. And you can do it down here. And what you'll have to do on this particular bag, if you have a canvas bag like the one I'm using, you'll actually have to cover to make yourself this nice frame, cover this part as well. Okay? Can you see that?
Yeah.
All right. So I've already done that on the other side.
Imagine that.
I know. I prepared today. Shocking. So I'm just going to take the board and switch it to the other side. And gesso doesn't take very long to dry anyway, so I'm really not concerned about laying this down on the table.
Oh, okay. So that just gave me a heart attack. So.
Okay. Well, you may jumpstart your heart again. It's okay. All right. So this is a dry gessoed side, and you can see the whole pretty swirly painted all over that. And now what I want to do is I want to take the Shimmer Mister, and this is a really dark turquoise, pretty dark color. And I'm going to spritz the top of this mister is actually a shimmer mister, so there's a slight amount of shimmer in it, so you really want to make sure it's mixed up. And what I'm going to do is just spray up here, and I want you to see how cool these misters are. They're from DecoArt Media. I just recently discovered them this weekend, and I'm in love because they actually spray. What?
Are they paint or ink?
These are paint, and they're acrylic. And so they actually spray where you want them to, and not that big circle halo thing, but like an actual spray, like a coverage. Here, let me just stop talking and show you.
Okay. Oh, imagine that. And that's paint spraying out like that.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
All right, so now I've got some water. And I'm just going to get it really wet and a little bit more spray here. And I want to see if I can drip on my canvas bag. That's what I'm trying to do. Yeah, look at that.
Oh, there you go.
So look at how intense that color is, even with adding all that water. And I added a lot of water. You can see I added a lot of water, right? I didn't plan ahead because I don't have paper towel handy.
This is why
I kept asking if anybody's ready to make a mess today, because I anticipated this fun.
Oh, that's so pretty. Okay, you have a question out there.
Okay.
Kim's asking, do you have other misters like Diane's or Tim's, and how do they compare?
Okay, they are not the same product because these are acrylic filled. So they're permanent when they're dry. It's as if you watered down paint and sprayed with it. But the sprayers are really, this is a really good mechanism because it doesn't do that halo with the blank in the center like we're used to with some sprays. You know, it's not doing that gummy up caked stuff. And it doesn't even have a BB inside to mix it up. So I don't know what their formula is. I have not done any research to figure out the answers to all the questions. All I know is that I am in love. Wow. Absolutely in love. So what I'm trying to do is bring some of that turquoise down to the bottom. A little bit more. I want it really dark up at the top and then just sort of bleeds down to the bottom, which I think it's doing pretty good. Now, why the gesso? Okay, here's where I'm making a big mess. Hold on, let me clean this off real quick here. I had just cleaned up my desk, by the way. I don't know if anyone noticed that or not, but
it was
so much for that. Yeah, so much for that. Okay, so baby wipes. And you know what? I have to yell for some help for, I need to get a paper towel, another paper towel roll. I just ran out. So hold on.
These misters are from DecoArt. That's what she's using today is DecoArt. Because we had a question about that. And while she's running upstairs or getting her paper that she needs, I just want to just do a quick little rundown. We've got BJ lives in Oklahoma and she found us on YouTube. Jules found us up from YouTube. Arthur's in Naples, Florida. Kim, and you'll see her name in there, is Kim Sims. She came from the Art Sherpa via YouTube. And then Trisha's YouTube, Carol, she can't remember, I think that's funny. Lynn's is coming to us in bed. Donna, who lives in Virginia, and she came via YouTube. Barbara from CC's at the New Year's Eve party, which was a rip-roaring fun time. Lynn's found us that way, too. Michael said, because Heather made me. And then Rhea's 3 years ago from CC on YouTube.
Awesome. That was great. Great to hear all that. Yeah. And I love that I made Michael come here. That's awesome.
Yes.
All right. So this is my background for my tote bag, which I think is awesome. I don't even have to do anymore. I could just live with that. I took some paper towel and just sort of wiped some of that spray off of the gesso. And in doing so, I'm kind of taking a little bit of color off of the bag itself. You can see that, right?
Yeah,
but it's not, it still looks really good. It's still very, very vibrant. I like it. I like it a lot. All right, so let's set that aside for just a tiny bit here. I'm going to get out some colors. Now, here's the thing with all sprays. You want to wipe off the nozzle. I don't do that with all my sprays, and maybe that's the reason why I've had a major hate relationship with sprays. Honestly, I don't know if it's Kim that had asked about my, if I own other sprays. I do. I own Diane's. I own Color Bloom from Prima. I own Lindy Stamp Gang. I own a couple of Tim Holtz sprays. I don't like any of them, honestly. I really don't. I don't use them often. You probably noticed that I don't use much of that on Kraaft It Live. Every once in a while, I try to bring them out and I get frustrated because they're clogged up and they just don't do what I want them to do. They're going to mix with everything else. And, you know, they're either the final layer, which I never think ahead enough for them to be the final layer. So it's not, it just isn't my cup of tea. There's nothing wrong with them. It just isn't my cup of tea. And because it's not my cup of tea, I don't do it. But these sprays are, they're permanent. So you're not, you can add whatever you want to over the top of this and they're not going to mix together once they're dry. So while they're wet, of course, like any paint, while they're wet, they will mix with each other, but we'll see what happens, huh? All right, so this is what I'm gonna do with my jelly plate. I'm just cleaning off my brayer with my little canvas flower here. So We've got the jelly plate. I'm trying to make sure I'm still on camera.
Yeah, you're right.
Okay. All right. Got the jelly plate with some color on it. And I'm just going to use my, what is this thing called? Canvas flower.
Canvas flower, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And, oh, I don't know if this will work. I don't think that will work too well. Let's do it like this. I kind of thought I might stamp it on there, but it doesn't really leave much. So this is what we're going to do. And I think I'm going to get the smaller plate out as well. Now this bag is soaking wet, by the way.
Mm.
Yeah, that's cool. I'm going to get out the smaller plates too. I have two other round ones that'll be a nice addition to this. I didn't really think that part ahead to have it ready. All right, and I like to put them on these acrylic blocks that I had made because then you can stamp with them. Super cool. So I've got the 6-inch, the 4-inch, and the 3-inch. We're going to do this a few times because I want to layer lots and lots of things on there. So we're going to do this pink color. Now, this is fabric paint, by the way. I think I said that in the beginning, but I'm going to make sure I say it again.
DecoArt fabric paint, right?
Yeah, it's called So Soft. It's very soft and pliable. Once it's dry, it's actually quite a nice. I made, you may remember that I made a set of clothes with it, a t-shirt and pair of capris, yeah. Mm-hmm. I use that for that. Let's take this bubble wrap, this gigantic bubble wrap. It's using, like I said in the beginning, a variety of techniques to create different marks on our bag. And
I love the ombre background. I think that's very pretty. I like that. Art's been a fan of that.
I think I want to put this through the stencil. Where did I put the other stencil? This will be kind of fun. Let's put this through here. Yeah, no. I like it, but I don't want to cover it up. I think I'm going to, though. Anyway. What's different about using a jelly plate on canvas, on material, is that it's different in the sense that you don't get multiple pulls off of it. Yeah, see, it lost the... I don't know if you can see that, but it doesn't really have the pattern of the bubble wrap anymore.
Mm-hmm.
There's some of it is in there. So what I want to do is a contrasting color of the bubble wrap. So we're going to go with a dark purple. And this is a metallic. That's the cool part about the DecoArt So Soft is because they come in neon and also like every color of the rainbow practically, and then they also have these metallics and shimmers, which is really cool. All right, the giant bubble wrap is one of my favorite texture tools on the jelly plate.
Yeah, I like it too.
There, that's what I'm after. Ah, yeah, that's what we like right there.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to do this one on here. And I like when you put it on a plate like this, on an acrylic block like this, because then you can actually go around the edges. See how I was able to get that edge mm-hmm. printed? Because I was able to push it onto there. So, all right. I need paper to pull those off, I think, because I'm not going to waste that. I can't possibly. I can't live with myself if I were to do that. Here, we'll pull it off on this.
And do the little one too, because you have that scroll that will come through.
Look at that.
Look at that.
See what I mean, the difference? You can get multiple pulls off the jelly plate using paper, but with material, it just really absorbs into the material, even the wet material. Okay, I'm leaving this the way it is and going to add some of this blue, but I think I'm going to mix it because I don't think it's going to stand off very well on this with a little bit of that pink. Actually, I should have grabbed a yellow. Yeah, there. Ooh, look at that. That's going to be fun. Okay, so now I'm going to smush this one onto there, transferring that texture, the mixture of color and everything to this one. Cute.
Jules is asking, because you're working with canvas and it's wet, does it blur around the edges because it's wet?
Are you able to see that? I don't know if you're able to see it there, but this is probably a good time for an Instagram picture.
Okay, good. Instagram.
All right, so you can see, and you know that the canvas bag is very, very wet. All right, come on. All right, so for those of you who are not on Instagram, it's not a big deal. You can still go to instagram.com/craftshack, and you should be able to see it now because it is posted. All right, so now I've got, I would say these are like flowers. And I'm going to actually use my jelly plate here as a palette and put on some greens. Brand new. I'm not using my teeth to open this. You didn't hear nothing.
Now, Heather, could you wipe that paint off of the gesso so it looks like it went to the background?
Yeah, I could. I want them to come forward, though. I want that the swirls to be in the background.
Okay.
So now I've got a paintbrush. So I'm just going to paint on some stems. Now they're starting to look like lollipops.
All day suckers.
I've been called worse. All right, so we've stenciled, we've jelly plated, now we're painting on with a paintbrush. All different ways that you can, and you can use paint, you can use sprays, you can use gesso even. All different ways to put art onto your canvas bag. I love what Lynn said about if you don't have a canvas bag, then take two canvases and create your own.
Two canvas, tape it together at the bottom, add tape at the top, and then you got a bag. There you go.
Don't forget your ribbon handle. Yep.
Yeah. Easy peasy.
So I had alluded to multiple times now that I am going on a trip at the end of this month.
And I know where.
Yes, you do. So it's kind of cool that I get to go. I talked about this on Monday Meanderings last week, is that going to go take my daughter and my granddaughter. They're in a wedding down in Arizona. So I get to go see family and friends like Sylvia. Kind of exciting. Big, and huge thank you to my family who's letting me do that. What did you say? I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
To go and everything, so. But I know she's going to be spending a lot of time with her family. It's not all my time.
It's not all my time. All right, so I have to say this publicly on Kraaft It Live while we're here together. The amazing Kim Sim, she is got to be the number one Instagram award or something, because she 9 times out of 10 is the very first person to like one of my page posts or something. So thanks, Kim. High five to Kim. All right, so I just put some gold. This is still fabric paint, by the way. Put some gold on there just to give some fun gold highlight there. Put that on top of this one. That's cool. I don't know if you can see it because it's kind of hidden a little bit, but it's on there. Fun. All right. What else do I want to do?
So cute.
I think I want to add some pink and orange swirls because I can.
Yeah, good job.
Yeah, you're not going to stop me. All right. You really should clean up your jelly plates a little better than I do, but I'm over it. Wow, that's a lot of paint for what I wanted to do. Apparently, I'm in the mood to waste paint today. All right. And because I can't function without painting with my fingers, that's what I'm choosing to do.
Wow.
Now they really look like an all-day sucker. That's actually kind of cute. I like that.
Yes.
I don't know if I'm going to leave it, though, but... Yeah, let's do this instead. A little bit of that in there.
Oh, I like the orange on that.
Yeah, I do too. All right. I think I'm going to do something similar in this one. Oh, I just mixed the colors. Oh, well. I'll live.
It's okay. It's good.
I'm going to wipe some of this orange back because it's a little bit more than I was hoping for, and I just wiped orange on my nose.
Instagram.
I'm not gonna see that. No, I'm not Instagramming that. Nice try. So it's just a baby wipe on my finger here, just to wipe some of that back and bring some of that purple forward. I can't believe I got that on my nose. I had sort of a sketch that I had sketched out about what I wanted to do, but this is about it. This is like where it ended. It's three flowers on this background.
I like the dots. Those are cute.
Okay. I like that. That's pretty good.
That's adorable.
I think I want to clean up my paint using my canvas flower. It didn't really end up being the texture tool that I thought it was going to be. I didn't quite use it that way.
BJ saying that she likes it, Heather. It's real cheery. Yeah, it is. It's real cute.
Well, I kind of wanted, well, this is where I was going when I was talking about what I'm cleaning up my flowers. We talked about this. Why I was doing this is because I wanted to have a bag that I could take my art supplies in. And I have lots of bags, and some of them, you know, are good for some things, but not good for everything. And I want to be able to take a very small amount of art supplies. And the journal that we made last time we were together, mm-hmm. if you remember, we went through and created the journal using the jelly plate last week. And I've added a few things like these sprays through a stencil on the front here. And I also did some permanent inks through stencil on the front and the back. And I've gone through and added some, a little bit of stenciling with the sprays. So these are more of these DecoArt sprays in different colors. The Shimmer Mister, or the non-shimmer, just the Mister. This dark cerulean blue, that is just a non-shimmery one. But anyway, this, I want to be able to put this in here and a couple of sketch pencils and some water brushes. You know, things that I can take and travel with easily and take on the plane and not have them, you know, kick me off the plane. And in order to do that, you have to minimize. Plus, the nowadays, oh gosh, everything, they don't let you just go on the plane with whatever you want to bring. They've got weight limits and all sorts of different things going on. So I wanted to make sure that I'm taking as little as possible and going to limit myself. That's going to be the challenge, to limit myself to be able to create with limited supplies. And I wanted something pretty to carry it all in. So I thought that would be good. There's a little bit of paint still wet on this. That's kind of cool. These canvas flowers from Canvas Corp Brand, you mm-hmm. can actually find these. I found them at my local Walmart, even.
Really?
Really, really. Yep. There's actually, in my Walmart, there's a new section that they just put up not too long ago. I want to say within the last couple of months, that is all, it's all, oh, like home decor stuff, like you could, you know, in the craft section, but it's all home decor stuff, like those signs that you can make out of wood pallets. You know what I'm talking about? Mm-hmm. They have wood pallets so you can make your own signs and stuff like that. It's kind of neat, I thought. But okay, so what you would want to do is obviously repeat, the word is repeat, this process on all of your sides and on the back. And even you could even add something to the bottom as well, just to finish the look off. You might want to finish your handles as well so that they look completed. And I think what I'm going to do, because I can, is I'm going to spray these handles. I really like these sprays.
Yeah. I just want to say a welcome to a new person who joined us. Her name is Joan. She comes from Kim Sim, you know, the one, Kim who, if you look in the viewers, is Kim Sim. She brought her over, and she's from Alberta. So welcome.
All right, glad welcome. You joined us today.
And she likes all sorts of crafty things and getting crafty.
All right, well, we're glad you're here. So I'm just cleaning up my mess with my flower. So this is pretty good and covered. There's still a few spots that are not, don't have something on them. Yeah, I like that. That's good. All right. Now I'm going to do something really weird. Set this guy down there and spray it all with the water, because the water is going to let that spray bleed somewhat, and some of the paint that might be still wet too. But of course it's going to run out of water right now. No worries. I'm prepared for that.
Okay, I just want to just do a shout out for Lynn, in case people missed her comment. She did a craft cartoon of Heather with the orange nose. It's really cute. It's up on Instagram.
Oh, thanks for that, Lynn. Thanks for that. See, this is the reason why I didn't take a picture. I knew I wouldn't need to.
So cute.
There we go. I'm making a huge mess.
Welcome. Is Andrew here? Very happy.
I know. I hope he's watching, or at least going to watch the replay. Speaking of which, you can catch the replay to all of our Kraaft It Live shows on YouTube or on our video treasure chest if you're looking for the ones with the comments and you want to see what everybody's saying about fun stuff. Some of that stuff we can't put up on screen, so it's the only place to see it is in the video treasure chest.
Yeah. There's a lot of stuff we don't share up on screen.
Yeah. You got to be there live or catch the recording on the treasure chest to see what goes on. All right. Now I'm thinking I like it. I got to let it dry, though. So I'm going to pull it up and kind of scrunch it so it'll dry like this. You see that, right? So it'll dry with some lift to it. It's like a big spiral. So it's not like there's layers, individual layers. It's like spiraled. So when I, okay, so see how dimensional it is? Mm-hmm. It'll dry like that now. And then I will safety pin that onto my bag as an embellishment. And I need a bath. All right, so with my mess here, just wipe it up. So this is, see how cool this is? I mean, these things just clean right up as long as they're wet. And actually on my Formica table here, they just wiped right off even after being dry all weekend. I did use them this weekend in the Patreon only hangout. I think some folks were talking about that. We had a good time and I was making, I'll show you that booklet here. What I made when I used the sprays. So it comes, the sprays, and again, this isn't sponsored by DecoArt or anything. I'm just sharing with you this new product that I think is really cool. And it's these misters. And they have 12 colors. And I believe 5 of them or 6 of them, maybe, I don't know how many are actually shimmery. Shimmer misters, like this one here has a shimmer to it, and then there's a yellow and a magenta, a violet. Anyway, these are how brilliant these colors are, and they go over the top of each other very well. So this yellow was sprayed, and then I sprayed on top, and then I went back in and sprayed more of the yellow, and just whatever I sprayed ended up on top. So this, the layers are really cool. The color's really bright and it's permanent. So when you go back in with something else, it won't smear and go all over the place. So that was a lot of fun to make those. And then we did do some jelly printing with them because I wanted to see what they'd be like on the jelly plate. Actually, I think I was dared to by some of the people in the hangout. But the sprays are pretty awesome, even on the jelly plate. So I've never experienced a spray that I could layer on top of and not disturb the underneath, and I love that. And I was really anxious to see what it would do on the canvas. And there it is on the handle. I'll spray the other side of the handle once I get to the other side as well. But I like that.
It's so cute. Oh my gosh.
I think when I get to the, I might do the other side. Kind of a different color scheme, maybe, just to add some dimension to it. We'll see. So what do you think? Any questions? I'm really didn't expect it to go so quickly. That's what I get for preparing ahead of time, see?
review the different paints that you used, okay?
Okay. So the spray was the background. The DecoArt Mister, I'm going to put it up here so you guys can see, it's by DecoArt Media Line. It is, this one is turquoise shimmer mister, and they have non-shimmered misters as well. And then I did use a variety.
There was a question. Those spray paints come in 12 colors, right?
Yeah, let me get them.
Okay. And, you know, once again, some of them are shimmer and some of them aren't.
Yeah, so here, I'll put the shimmers here. You can see all this, right?
And they want to know where they're available, DecoArt sprays. You can always order online, but I think you can get them at Michael's, right? I'm not really sure. It's the media. You have to, because that's like a fluid.
Okay. All right, so these are, I'll take these out too so there's no confusion. Okay, these are the regular Mr. Sprays. They come in red.
Ready.
Lime, or yellow green. I keep calling it lime green, but it's yellow green. Orange. Yellow, it's primary yellow. The primary cyan. Purple, very dark purple, black, and primary magenta. So those are the regular non-shimmery sprays right there. Then they have four shimmer sprays, the turquoise you saw me use today, another yellow, but it's a different, it's kind of a darker yellow. Can you see the difference between them? This one's shimmery, this one is not, but it also has more of a darker tone to it. And that's the shimmer that you can see at the bottom, but you can kind of tell that it's the shimmer you see at the bottom, so that's not a very good example there. But then we have shimmer violet and shimmer white. Mm. Okay, so that's the sprays, the DecoArt Media Line sprays. Where can you buy these? The best place to buy them that I have found is online by going to the DecoArt Media site. DecoArt Media, and then you click you buy on our online store. It's not easy to find, so if you want the link, I can give it to you when we're done here. But
I'll go look
anyway,
for
this, they're the cheapest. They're the cheapest way to get them, and they, as far as I know, they ship all over the world. So anyway, so that's kind of cool. That's the whole set right there. Very, very cool set of sprays. Okay, and then I also use the So Soft, which is also a DecoArt product, the So Soft fabric paints, and it comes in different colors as well as metallics. Like these two are metallics. I don't think I used any shimmery ones today. I used all flat and then two metallics, the purple and the gold were metallic. And then I also used some Simply Acrylic to do that finger painting on top. These are neon colors by Dalarowney. I just got these at Walmart. I also used DecoArt's Media Gesso in their media line. I think that's all that I used. I'm looking around to see, but I'm pretty sure that's all that I used. Anyway, looking almost dry, not quite.
I did put the link in for the DecoArt store, and I put their home page in, so when you get there, you'll see all the products that they have to offer. And they're really, really pretty quick about, you know, shipping them, too, because I've ordered from them, and I think they have great service. So.
Yeah, and I think we were looking on Saturday to try and find them, like, on Amazon or whatever, and the prices varied so drastically across the internet. That the DecoArt just seemed to be the most affordable site to go to get them, but mm-hmm. So was I did see a question about being able to spray directly onto the jelly plate. So since we've got time, I'll show you that.
Okay, and another question also is AKP.
Oh, not today, guys. I just not able to do AKP today. We might, for those who are new, AKP is short for After Crafter Party. It's kind of like a backstage pass to coming in and hanging out afterwards, but we're not able to do that today. All right, so this is the jelly plate that I used. We're just going to activate the whole thing by spraying on it. And...
oh, I like how it kind of beads.
Well, it's definitely going to bead because I have acrylic paint on there. So let's just pull some of this up, see what happens. This is mostly just to clean it off so we can show you exactly what happens. But remember that the jelly plate is a petroleum-based gelatin. So these are water-based. So when you spray on them, it's going to bead up a little bit. You're going to experience some of that because it oil and water don't mix. You don't even need an art degree to know that. Okay, so this is just pulling up some of it. Okay, so that was just to pull up off the plate what we could get off the plate. So, where's my stencil? Did I put the stencil back? Very cool. So easy to just spray directly on it. And because of the way that these sprays work, you can actually put the spray where you want it. And if you have one of my biggest pet peeves with spray is I'm trying to spray here and the spray ends up going over here or worse in my own eye or something like that. Seems like sprays are just too finicky for me. But this one, I can actually spray just a little bit in one tiny spot right where I want it to go, or I can spray the whole thing. I love it. I absolutely love it. And this is a shimmer mister, so it's got some yummies as it dries, some yummy shimmer to it.
Wow.
Let's change colors after we play with this one. Hold on. That's my stencil clean off there. I need more paper. I'm running out of paper. Can you believe that? And it doesn't dry any faster than the other paints seem to me. I can take multiple pulls. Pull after pull after pull. I'm pretty sure it's done now.
Wow.
My little ghost print there. All right, let's put the yellow on. So it's just amazing to me. These colors are just pretty crazy. And we're just going to spritz a little bit of this magenta just so we can mix, right? Because mixing is fun. Let's put the plate over the top there. And because it's liquid, it's not as crisp.
I like that though.
It's just a whole different layer of texture again.
Yeah. Oh, look at that.
See, it's so fun. You could do so many things with this. So let's just go ahead and put this last little bit on top of that purple there and see what happens. Just adds a little bit more there. But there was some question about whether the jelly plate is like sticky now. No stickier than it is with everything else that is on it. because again, these are acrylic sprays. So it's just like you're using your acrylic paints, only in a more watery and spray format instead of rolling it out with the brayer. So the texture obviously is different, but the finish is so fun. All right, and let's go in with one last one that's cyan. Just love the texture of it. Okay, and so then we're left with some mixture of the green or the yellow on there, and let's just add it to this one here and see what happens. So we went from decorating a canvas bag to jelly plating with sprays, but but it's still, it's so much fun. I mean, it never ends, right? And the cleanup, you know, if you really need to clean up your jelly plate, it's not that big of a deal. It's the same as it was before. Just baby wipes to the rescue. And baby wipes will clean up the whole thing, including the acrylic block and everything. So you don't want to watch me do all that, do you? But I just wanted to prove that it just wipes right off. So.
Yeah. Joan said that she just put some acrylic paints in some spray bottles, watered them down, and put a small fish weight in a bead in them so that they would shake. And she says they're working okay, but the colors aren't as vibrant.
You know, yeah, that has been my experience too. That's what I'm saying. I've made all my own homemade sprays. I've made paint sprays. And it's the same thing. I've even put the BB in just like she did with the fish weight. But it's the same thing. I either get a watered down version of the color that I wanted. I've even made sprays using, oh, good grief. Let me grab it because I don't want to call it the wrong thing. Hold on. Airbrush medium. This stuff is expensive. So here's a bottle of airbrush medium. What was this, like $12 or $15, I think, for this bottle is like 8 ounces. This is 2 ounces. So I can make 4 of these, probably 5, and then add some acrylic paint to them. But the vibrancy is still gone. Even though this doesn't water it down the same way water does, it's still less pigment. I don't know what their formula is, and I'm not even going to try to find it, you know. But to get a spray bottle that works, plus 2 ounces of very vibrant color that does some amazing stuff like that, I think it's worth buying. And you don't hear me say that too often.
Yeah. I want to put up this one comment because this
okay, is I'm going to listen.
Pretty good news here. Okay. This is JC. She just got off the phone and she'll be featured in an agency's newsletter where she'll be leading an art group session. She's thrilled and they're calling back in 15 minutes for the interview. And she's tickled pink. Congratulations, JC.
Way to go, JC.
Excellent news.
Very proud of our crafters when they get recognized for the talents and abilities they have. That's awesome. Way to go, girl. All right. That's pretty much it for me. This is the end of the show. Bye-bye. No, I'm just kidding. We'll show the bag again. I was just going to hang up, you know. No, I'm just kidding. So there it is. That's that. I love how bright it is up on top and how it just sort of fades down to the bottom. I love that. You could do the opposite if that's the way you'd want it to go. I just knew all the color was going to go down here, so that's why I wanted it darker at the top. I think it'll be cool to have it be dark all the way around. Mm-hmm. I'm going to finish putting the gesso down on this side, and I'll just basically do the same thing. And I'll probably spray the whole thing, sides, with that teal, or I'm sorry, it's turquoise, not teal, and have it drip down on the sides as well. That'll be a very cool bag. And I'll be taking that with me when I go on my trip. What do you think?
That's beautiful. I can't wait to see it.
All right. So I think that's pretty much it. If you've enjoyed today's show, I'd really appreciate you telling a friend. You know, like everybody who's here today said, somebody shared it with them, and that's why they're here. So I appreciate that. Even if it was me with a gun to Michael's head, at least he showed up, right? I really do appreciate you guys joining us live. If you're watching the recording, we appreciate comments in recording as well. So always very happy to have you leave comments when you're watching on YouTube or wherever you happen to be watching. And I have to tell you that I am incredibly grateful that each and every one of you have joined us, but especially Lynn's, because we have missed you so much, sweetheart. I hope you're feeling better. And to everyone out there who is not feeling 100%, I'm praying for you. So let's have a fabulous crafty day. Thank you all for joining. Thank you, Sylvia, for being here. Appreciate it.
Okay, bye, everybody. Thanks for joining us.